Hello, everybody. I'm Boyd Pearson. Welcome to Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. Another tremendous card this week. You'll see in action the muscular Tony Atlas, Mr. USA. Also, Stagger Lee versus Matt Bourne. Colonel Buck Robley joins forces with Mr. Wrestling 2 in tag team match. Iron Mike Sharp versus Kelly Kaniski. King Cobra versus Louisiana champion Hacksaw Duggan. Popular Chavo Guerrero makes his debut against the Masked Grappler. Right now, our guest commentator, Cowboy Bill Watts, is at the ring with two interesting guests. So let's go and listen to what they have to say.
Well, I'm here in Mid-South and the Irishman Neal Boys Club to interview the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. They're proud of themselves because they've gone down an infamy in the annals of professional wrestling. They pulled a trick or a subterfuge out of the history books, almost like the horse in Troy in ancient Greek history, with Hacksaw Duggan camouflaged. But DiBiase, you and Bourne don't seem to be too happy about the situation where you've won the titles, you've got all the accolades except the Mississippi title wrapped up in your little clique, and you've done something nobody's been able to do. You forced Mid-South to have the Junkyard Dog, the man who set more box office records than any wrestler in the world, to have to leave Mid-South for 90 days.
That's just the point. The man was supposed to leave for 90 days, and he's not gone. He's here. S. Lee, Stagger Lee, everybody in Mid-South, all these people here, Boyd Price sitting over there, everybody knows who S. Lee is. He's the Junkyard Dog. My partner knows it, I know it, and even you, Bill Watts, I used to have a lot of respect for you because you were right down the middle of the line, and even you are condoning this, Esley. You know that's a Junkyard Dog.
Well, Ted, when you're talking about respect, that's the same thing I've lost for you, but not for the same reason. But if you want to get into the situation, who is the Grappler? Would you like to reveal his identity here?
I don't know who the man
is. What about Mr. Wrestling, too?
I don't know who he is.
Well, the same thing. The biggest fool probably in Mid-South was me. Because I stood right over there. We had a bunch of fine young kids from Lanesville, Texas. The state fair was going on, and I thought the guy in the gorilla suit was just part of one of the sideshows come to invite the fans to be here. Instead, it was Hacksaw Duggan, and I didn't know who he was until he took his mask off. And wait a minute. Let's replay. We'll join that in progress, the final moments of that no disqualification match for the Mid-South Tag Titles.
Body slam. Got to be taking its toll. This goes television time remaining. Now they're going to double slam, which again would be illegal, but with no disqualification, it's legal as they are really, really hurting Mr. Olympia. They're trying to, naturally, he would be the target. DiBiase feels the dog has so much pride that would Olympia lose the Mid-South Tag Titles when the dog may still fall. They're trying to put every kind of pressure on the Junkyard Dog. Through his friends, through his family, through his tag team partners. DiBiase tagging in. Olympia trying to fight out, but DiBiase trying to keep the fresh man in all the time. They're doubling up again, a double clothesline. JYD tried to get down the tag Olympia, but couldn't. Power slam by DiBiase. There's that bombs away. There's that bombs away right there. Right there, that's what Matt Bourne was brought here for. DiBiase brought him here to try to injure Mr. Olympia. DiBiase has Mr. Olympia hurt on the crack of his sternum and his chest. JYD came in and dropped the headbutt in. That would ordinarily be a DQ, but it's not. JYD is saving his partner. He's dragging him over where he can make the tag. JYD made the tag. He's in there. He's the legal man in. He and DiBiase. Right away, DiBiase. JYD blocked it, and it's flying Mayor DiBiase in the ring. JYD's going for whatever's in that glove. But behind him, Matt Bourne's starting to climb the ropes. JYD's getting whatever out of the glove. Matt Bourne's coming off. JYD's got the object of DiBiase. What's that gorilla doing out there? That guy just, that's Duggan!
That's Duggan!
Boyd Pearce, that's Duggan! He attacked him, dog. He going for the spear, but he went for the spear. Hacksaw Duggan speared the dog. Hacksaw had speared the dog. And remember, this is no disqualification. DiBiase has picked up the foreign object and has put it in the glove. And DiBiase has just teed off on the dog. Boyd, I can't believe it. The Junkyard Dog has just lost the Mid-South title, and the Junkyard Dog, by decree of the contract, will be the man that is forced to leave Mid-South for 90 days, Boyd Pierce. Boyd, I just don't know what to say about it.
Well, there you have it, and it was a no disqualification, and Junkyard Dog had to leave, but Hacksaw Dugan in a gorilla suit. What will you stoop to next in your way of
conquest? Wait a minute, what I stoop to, Bill Watts, the stipulation was no disqualification. They knew the stipulation. That means anything goes. My partner Hacksaw Dugan had a little thing happen that took place over in Houston, Texas, that involved Tully Blanchard and Gino Hernandez, and we took a little bit from that happening over there and incorporated it into our own situation. The point is, it was no disqualification. We did win the match. Did we win the match?
That's correct.
But was Junkyard Dog not supposed to
leave? Well, where do you get off? Where do you get off beating around the bush talking about Dugan? The issue is the dog. The dog, the loser has to leave
down.
He's supposed to be gone. Dugan has nothing to do with it.
S. Lee, that's a Junkyard Dog and all these people, and you know it too.
Well, we'll rejoin where S. Lee made his debut here last week. Let's look at that now.
And now a non-title event for one fall with a 10-minute time limit.
All right.
In the red corner at 268 pounds from Omaha, Nebraska, the North American heavyweight champion, Ted DiBiase. And coming into the ring now at 150 pounds from Virginia, S. Lee.
And it's big deal. Who is Stagger Lee?
Who is Stagger Lee? Well, here comes Stagger Lee.
Stagger Lee, S. Lee is Stagger Lee, and DiBiase, he seems really upset, and I know he is. Stagger Lee out there rocking and rolling. And if I believe my memory serves me right, J.Y.D. referred to one Stagger Lee as a man who used to beat him up and steal his milk money on the bus when he was in school. And there is Stagger Lee. Like I said, J.Y.D. had a premonition of what they had in store for him. And therefore, he must have had Stagger Lee in the wings, because Stagger Lee just put something in that mask, and he hit. There's a foreign object in that mask, and that DiBiase is out on the floor with his head ringing, and Stagger Lee had just whipped him and then just dumped him. Well, right there you have it, Bill Watts. You watched the thing for yourself. You saw the man come in the ring. You saw the way he moved around. Who else uses that perfected move called the thump that he put on me? And on top of that,
you really didn't put up enough competition for me to tell how long he was moving around, DiBiase. He whipped you so fast.
Yeah, sure he whipped me. He loaded that mask and busted me in the head.
You've been loading a glove for a long time. You know what happened to the young Ted DiBiase that used to win fair and square? You don't like it when it happens to you in reverse, do you?
That's your personal opinion, Bill Watts. The issue is, was that or was that? What do you think? What do you think? Was that or was that?
I really don't know. I don't know who S. Lee is. We send the checks to a post office box just like we did for the grappler, just like for Mr. Wrestling too. And I guess if we'd had to pay for the gorilla, just like we did for the gorilla, because we sure didn't know who he was either. Now, are you sure, and you're beyond any reasonable shadow of a doubt, that S. Lee is the Junkyard Dog?
Yes,
you know it's him. I know it's him. Ted knows it's him, and everybody out there knows it's him.
Everybody,
and I really can't believe that you're
protecting the man because they don't like what happened.
I think it's a conspiracy.
Just before we went on the air here, I watched a workout with one of the strongest men in the world, Mr. USA Tony Atlas. He did something no other wrestler's ever done in public. He bench pressed 550 pounds. But the key thing is, two of the men there to spot him in that workout was Junkyard Dog and Stagger Lee. Let's watch that for a moment, Ted, and then you tell me what you think. We're here at the Irish McNeil Boys Club. You wonder how these guys work out. Well, here's one of the strongest men in the world, Mr. USA Tony Atlas. He's getting ready to do 500 pounds on the bench press. The Junkyard Dog and Stagger Lee standing by here to spot him on this. He's going to do it. Try to do two reps with 500 pounds, and then he'll come back later and do 550 pounds. This is something few people ever get to see done, and there's only an elite few that have ever done it. Unless you've done something like this, you don't know the pressure, the mental preparation, the strength preparation that goes in, a lot of concentration. This is an art. It's a skill all its own. He's got to be psyched out. He's got to be pumped. He's got to be heavy. His feet set. He's got to be completely ready. You're going to see those steel turbines and those 22-inch arms get ready to blow it off that chest. He'll come down to his chest and right up.
Rock with it, Dennis. Rock with it. Rock with it. Rock with it.
Okay, you just saw him do 500 pounds, JYD, and then we're going to reload it. We're going to go to 550 pounds, and JY, you're one of the men that's bench-pressed in this range. Well, just tell the people what that feels like.
It feels real good, man. It's sure you got strength, it's sure you got a little bit of knowledge about lifting these weights, and furthermore, I got a lot of other things to show these people, and don't get too close to my man Stagger Lee there because I'm working it right now.
Well, I was wanting to ask him a couple of questions because he shocked some people here last week with DiBiase, and I think that you have a little something to do with that. You've mentioned Stagger Lee in your past. Something to do with milk money and riding a school bus?
Used to beat milk when I was a kid and take my milk money, but now I got him here to beat up somebody else and take their milk money.
Do you think we can get an interview while Tony's getting himself ready for the 550, or you're saying you don't want us to talk to Stagger Lee?
Interview with me or him?
What's Stagger Lee?
Oh, no, I talk for Stagger Lee. I brought him in here. I talk for Stagger Lee. He don't say nothing. Okay, he just stand there.
Okay, partner. What are you going to do for 90 days?
I'm going to sit around and buy myself a ticket, go to every arena I want to, and take care of my man Stagger Lee, drive around that big 450 Mercedes I'm driving.
Okay. Well, here it comes. Here's Tony Atlas, and we're ready to see him try an attempt on 550 pounds. He's got to be so set mentally. You just can't imagine when you know you've got like a house coming down on you. It's the steel plates. These are 45-pound plates. Each one's a 45-pounder, coming down to a 25 on the end plus the Olympic bar. One of you there at home, try this sometime with a lot less weight, and you'll get some idea of what it takes. We want everybody quiet now.
Rock with it.
Lock it out. Push it. You got it. You got it. 555. And Ted, there you saw. There was not only Stagger Lee, but there was the Junkyard Dog as Mr. USA did that 550-pound prone. So you're sure that Stagger Lee is a Junkyard Dog?
Hey, look, there's something funny going on here. I can't really explain what I just saw on that piece of film. But I am still convinced that the Stagger Lee is Junkyard Dog. The point is, none of us are going to know until that mask comes off of him, right?
Well, we're not going to take it off of him.
That's right. I'm not going to take it off of him because my partner here has signed a contract to wrestle S. Lee right here today on this television program, and we're going to take that mask off of him. My partner is going to take that mask off of him, and if that's a junkyard dog, am I right? If that's a junkyard dog and that mask comes off, he is suspended and he's got to go.
If you can prove to Mid-South beyond any shadow of a doubt that S. Lee is a junkyard dog by unmasking him, then you're right. He has violated his contract, and he will be suspended from Mid-South Wrestling.
That's right. Now, let me get this straight. You mean to say if I take Stagger Lee's mask off right here on TV, and it proves to be JYD, that he is out for 90 days?
He's out for more than 90 days. He's out for probably a year. But you've only got 90 days to prove it because JYD's
on. You guarantee me that?
I guarantee it.
That's great because then you don't have to go out there and beat the man.
Matt Bourne will be against Stagger Lee later today here on Mid-South Wrestling.
I'm telling you
now,
right now.
We'll go to these words from sponsors of Mid-South Wrestling Network.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 300 pounds from Moscow, Russia, Vladik Smirnov. And in the blue corner at 252 pounds from Roanoke, Virginia, Mr. USA Tony Atlas.
The introduction of the match from Moscow, Russia, the powerful Cossack star Vladik Smirnov. And talk about power, his opponent, Mr. USA Muscular Tony Atlas. Bill Watts?
Well, I'll tell you, Vladik Smirnov has been undefeated so far on Mid-South Television Wrestling, and he's up against the toughest test that he's had here. And you all saw earlier Tony Atlas do an incredible bench press. And bench pressing and weightlifting is just one part of these great wrestlers' regimen to stay in shape and to increase their strength. They also have to do a lot of aerobic things. They've got to do running and racquetball and skipping the rope and a lot of time in the gym. So it's a profession that's very, very demanding. And you see one of the ones that has perfected it. Here's a youngster. I heard a great comment from him. Somebody accused him of not being completely schooled, and he said, a lot of people pick on me about my education. He said, I'm the first to admit, I went to school. I went in the front door and out the back door. And he said, it set me back. And he said, I'm having to learn every day and learn everything the hard way. And he said, I don't advocate it for the youngsters. He said, if I had to do all over, I'd stay in school and I'd make the grades. But he said, I've had to work twice as hard in the gymnasium and push myself twice as hard in order to get ahead. But he said, the fortunate thing about wrestling is no matter what, it comes down to basic instincts of survival right in the middle of this squared circle. And he said, as long as I know I got the power to bench press 550 or 600 pounds, he said, I know nobody's going to overrun me strength-wise. There's not that many places to hide in this ring. So I think Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, is one of the top in the world. And we'll see Vladik Smirnov, a big, huge man. And so far, he hadn't been able to push Mr. USA around. Of course, Ted DiBiase very upset, but we have the challenge in that Matt Bourne is booked next against S. Lee. And if Matt Bourne can unmask, he doesn't have to beat S. Lee. It's not under the regular stipulations. If he can unmask at any time in that match, S. Lee, and prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that that's a junkyard dog, the dog is in violation of a contract and would be suspended from Mid-South for 1 year. But he only has 90 days from the date of that original contract, which was the 27th of October, to prove that it's a dog. We're saying tongue-in-cheek that we have no idea who S. Lee is. But it looks like S. Lee could be a Trojan horse, just like Hacksaw Dugan was in the gorilla suit. Look at the power. Look at this. A straight body press of 300 pounds. And Tony Atlas slammed Vladik Smirnov crashing to the mat. Atlas getting up and headbutt. The big Russian bear may decide to hibernate right here.
And the victor, Mr. USA Tony Atlas. We'll be back. S. Lee versus Matt Bourne after this message from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 240 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, co-holder of the Mid-South Tag Team Championship belts, Matt Bourne.
Stagger Lee through seven, Billy swore that
came in the ring, and Matt Bourne hadn't wasted any time. And like I say, there's no rules or regulations as far as taking that mask off in this match like in an ordinary one, because if he can prove it's a Junkyard Dog, the match wouldn't count anyway, but the Junkyard Dog will be suspended from Mid-South Wrestling, and they got 90 days from the 27th of October to prove that. Matt Bourne, after that mask, Ted DiBiase looking on intently because he certainly wants to know. Stagger Lee getting the worst of it at this point. Matt Bourne throwing him back in the ring. I don't know if a bell ever rang or not. This is just a physical effort out there with Matt Bourne. Fireman's carry by Bourne. He gets Stagger Lee down, and he's trying to pull off that mask. Matt Bourne starting to use the flat of the foot. Stagger Lee fighting back with the forearm there. DiBiase up there, referee Rick Farrar telling DiBiase to stay out of it. Stagger Lee firing back now. He throws one at DiBiase, and as he turns his back, Matt Bourne catches him. Body slam. Matt Bourne going for the bombs away off the top turnbuckle. Matt Bourne dropping on Stagger Lee. Now DiBiase in there. Crowd cheering him. They pulled the mask off. It's not Junkyard Dog, but there's another Stagger Lee in there. That other Stagger Lee is firing away. They pulled the mask off.
Millie are going crazy, and now excitement everywhere. We'll be back with exciting tag team action after this message.
It's tag team action now for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 240 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, Tony Anthony. And his partner at 250 pounds from Rome, Georgia, Marty Lundy. And in the blue corner at 242 pounds from Amarillo, Texas, Colonel Buck Robley. And his partner at 236 pounds, a former North American heavyweight champion, Mr. Wrestling 2.
Tag team action now, Tony Anthony and Marty Lundy in the black against Colonel Buck Robley and Mr. Wrestling 2. Two men with tactics different as daylight and dark, Bill, but no greater competitors in professional sports than these two.
Them a lot of experience. Wrestling too, he gets like wine, he gets finer with time. He's like Kenny Stabler, George Blanda, you know, like Jim Marshall of the Minnesota Vikings. The more longer he's out there, it just seems like he can go on. He's got so much experience and so much intensity and desire that you have to respect him. He doesn't ask it, he demands it. Noting one thing, that his mask has been very badly discolored, and I saw him when he came in this night, and he was steaming, he was foaming. And he said that somebody has done some sabotage and there's something going on he doesn't like. He wouldn't really elaborate on it a great deal, but that they had destroyed or they have done something to his mask. He doesn't know who. He's not sure why. He said there's more to it than meets the eye, and he'll discuss it with me after today's television taping. But Wrestling 2 is somebody you just don't mess with. There was a guy was an imposter of him in Atlanta, Georgia, and he whipped that guy so bad he got right out of wrestling business. And of course the grappler came in and tried to become the imposter, and Wrestling 2 has not only whipped him, he's exposed him. So Wrestling 2 is just not somebody to mess with. Neither is the Colonel, a man out there that says nobody calls me yellow. He's a tough cookie too. These guys are a lot of experience. They could be a real threat to the new Mid-South tag champions of DiBiase and Bourne. Of course, DiBiase and Bourne Maybe something's happened that they're getting trapped in their own subterfuge. Maybe two can play that game. I'm not sure what all's going on right now, but it's apparently elaborate. And they were set up to gang up and unmask S. Lee. And apparently S. Lee or Stagger Lee kind of suspected that and kind of figured that move. And he sent out a little Trojan horse of his own, somebody to take his place and have their attention until he could come in from behind and really clean house. And, of course, the crowd loved it. And I have to admit that I try to be unbiased and not too prejudiced. I sit right here and I love it, too, because S. Lee, has, I feel, is a lot closer connected to Junkyard Dog than anybody realized. Dog said there was an S. Lee in his background that was so tough he used to take his milk money on the bus and everything else, and that's the only man that ever whipped him. But I'll tell you, there is a remarkable similarity, but of course without proof we won't call it. But we will call the fall there. Wrestling 2 and Buck Robley take it.
And we'll be back when action continues after this word from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
And now a battle of the big Canadians. This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 264 pounds from Vancouver, British Columbia, Kelly Koniski. And in the blue corner at 278 pounds from Hamilton, Ontario, Iron Mike Sharp.
Iron Mike Sharp raised his hand as the people clap. Rick Ferreira called for the bell. Mike Sharp from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Kelly Koniski across the continent to Vancouver, British Columbia. Bill?
Iron Mike Sharp, a man who said he can personally attest to the awesome, unorthodox power of Kamala, the Ugandan giant. Mike said he never witnessed anything so devastating, and then he was in the ring with the man. He said the man is just phenomenal in size and strength and agility, and you just really don't know what to attack on him, because even though he doesn't have the inherent skills or the learned skills of the wrestler, he's just an awesome warrior. And the devastating, battering person with no heart. And coming from Iron Mike, you can almost capitalize every one of those words, because Mike is a man of few words. Mike in here with Kelly Koniski. We have King Cobra against Hacksaw Dugan, the Louisiana heavyweight champion. We have Chavo Guerrero, the Mexican sensation we watched a few weeks ago, almost a month ago, a tape from Tokyo where he had gained the World's Junior Heavyweight Championship in Tokyo. This man is a tremendous athlete. Comes from a wrestling family. So many of these guys, family background. Kelly Koniski's father, Gene, was world's champion. Matt Bourne's father, Tough Tony Bourne. You can see why Matt says has a better outlook on life. His father had the same, Ted DiBiase. I hate to think what his father, Iron Mike, he was a rough, tough guy, but he wasn't a man of subterfuge or cunning. He beat you just by coming head on physically and strapping it to you. Teddy is good. Uh-oh, good move by Sharp, standing out of the way of that drop kick, and Kelly Koniski pays the price. But Chavo Guerrero comes from a great wrestling family. He has to have the skills. He's not as big as the rest, but he's got the heart and the power and the quickness to go with it. And I'll tell you, he gained national and international recognition was in Los Angeles, California, in front of a packed record house. Chavo Guerrero defeated Ernie Ladd some 5 years ago, 4 years ago, and the wrestling world said, who is this fella? Well, they've been finding out ever since. Mel Moscris, another great Mexican star, is going to be appearing in the Mid-South area in the near future. Of course, you fans in Houston, quite familiar with the exploits of this man as Chavo Guerrero. I might say Paul Bosch, watching closely, he and Peter Burkholz. A lot of great things happening. Kelly Koniski carrying the fight. Iron Mike Sharp, powerful man, Kelly. Also played football at West Texas State. Of course, we'll see. Got Sharp down for the pin. Could be a big feather in Kelly's cap to beat the former Louisiana champion right here on Mid-South Television. He hits that drop kick again. It caught him a glancing blow. Big as Kelly is, that could be a telling blow. 1-2, Ricky Ferrara kicks, but Mike Sharp's out. Kelly is really carrying the fight, too. Iron Mike. Mike is reaching in. He just tackled Kelly, picked him up and over like a bale of grain. And Mike Sharp shows why he's called the Iron Man when he starts laying those forearm smashes on you. Kelly into the ropes. Mike Sharp firing away. He just throwing Kelly like a 275-pound rag doll, if you can imagine a 275-pound rag doll. But that's what the Iron Man's doing with him, so you can compare the power of Kamala. Kamala, by the way, the only man that I know of recently to beat the Junkyard Dog in downtown New Orleans. A man to be reckoned with. Can you imagine a match between he and Stagger Lee? Inside cradle by Mike. Kelly firing back. Forearm smashed by Kelly. These two men are really going after each other, tooth and nail. Mike Sharp showing that agility out. He clotheslines him. He caught him by surprise, and he has him.
And the victory to Iron Mike Sharp. We'll be back. King Cobra versus Louisiana heavyweight champion Hacksaw Dugan after this message from Mid-South.
This is a non-title event for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 270 pounds from New York City, the Louisiana heavyweight champion Hacksaw Dugan. And in the blue corner at 236 pounds from Chula, Mississippi, King Cobra.
The Louisiana champion, heavyweight division from New York State, the foot stomping Hacksaw Dugan versus popular Mississippi star King Cobra. Bill?
This will be a great match. Hacksaw Dugan, Louisiana champion, as you said. Man proud of SMU, made more starts as an All-American athlete there than any other athlete they've had. He's proud of the record SMU has thus far. He said he'd like to see SMU come down here and kick LSU right in Tigerland. Well, I'll tell you, Bear Bryant thought he's going to come down and kick them too. So LSU's just not too easy to kick in Tigerland. Dugan was overpowering the Cobra, but the Cobra's using that skill and that speed, and that's the difference. If somebody's awesome in power, you got to figure a way to cope with it. And the Cobra just let the Hacksaw Dugan know he was there to be reckoned with, and the crowd loves it.
And Dugan is hot.
That's right, but the Cobra found another way. You know, if you just can't go into an awesome onslaught, it's like charging a machine gun nest. You just know you're not going to get there. You got to figure a way to outflank it. And Dugan's coming back with that battering ram power. Like Marvelous Marv, boxer, he does not fancy, but he keeps firing at you. He's got Cobra in trouble, but Cobra comes out. Again, Cobra shows that motion, but he went to the well once too often. He had a lot of success with the drop kicks and went back, and Dugan was looking for it. Tell you, you don't play in the NFL, even if you're on the suicide squad, if you don't have some brain power. Dugan up. Looks like almost Dugan is starting a little cat and mouse of his own. He wants to punish him. This is the thing about Hacksaw. He believes in punishing people. Cobra whirled and squirmed, and Dugan lost his balance. King Cobra is showing that he's got some experience too. The man from Chula, Mississippi, going for that drop kick again. Miss Dugan didn't get him solid, but he's up and fighting. Dugan trying to get Cobra. Cobra going off the top. Dugan just met. Boy, did you see what I just saw. Dugan just sat there and waited and speared the Cobra in midair. One of the most vicious. That man cares nothing for his own safety.
And Cobra's still down. Dugan the victor. We'll be back. Chavo Guerrero versus the grappler after this message. Bone.
This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner at 242 pounds, the former North American heavyweight champion, the grappler. And in the blue corner at 223 pounds from Mexico City, Chavo Guerrero.
Action continues now. The masked grappler versus Chavo Guerrero. Bill Watts told you earlier, about all the things and all the accolades that he's gained in the past few years. Bill, his father, Salvador Gory Guerrero, my friend of years past, so he comes with great credentials.
Well, he's up against a man with great credentials, too. This could be a great bout. These men both have a lot of scientific background. They're both great competitors because the grappler's been the North American champion. Wow! What a move. I have never seen a head scissor like that. Boy, I'm just amazed. Like I say, this guy comes with all the accolades. Listen to the crowd give him a hand. They really appreciate that. They're seeing some technical skills here that few people possess. The man has the quickness and the smoothness of a lightweight, but he's got the punching power and the strength of a heavyweight. That's an awesome combination. Reminds me of a Danny Hodge in many ways. The tremendous athlete that Danny was and could float between the junior heavyweight, and he could also take on the heavyweights. Chavo used everything, including the ropes, to confuse the grappler. The grappler, the man with the orthopedic shoe, one fall of television time remaining between these two. This could be quite a contest. Next week, Stagger Lee will be back. Also, Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. Chavo Guerrero will be back. 3 minutes airtime left here. Chavo's got the grappler really tied up. You know, somebody can tie up your legs like that. You have a hard time basing up to back up the referee's position. And you can't move off your belly. He got him into, what is that, Boyd? A bow-type move there. Look at the way he's got him tied up. I've got to tell you, I enjoy seeing skills like that. That shows the experience level he's gained from wrestling all over the world. Well, the grappler says, I'm going to quit to the skill level because I'm outclassed. I'm going to take it to him in a fight and see if he's got the guts to stay with me. And the grappler's certainly been in some fights with some tough ones. 2 minutes airtime remaining. Grappler going for the atomic drop. And he's really carrying it to Chavo right now. Going for the fall. He can have Chavo pinned. You know, that's the thing about the heavyweight division is you can go into that pinfall at any second because you got the size and strength to do it. Where the lighter weights have to really wear somebody down, and generally the falls aren't as sudden. Chavo Guerrero, that's what I'm saying. He hits like Jose Lothario. He hits like a big, huge man at the 220. Look at the power he has. A wiry individual. He and Mil Máscaras, the two top Mexican athletes in the world today. Mill being a big movie star and everything back in his homeland. Chavo showing again that, look at the reckless abandon. He attacks it. 1-2, it almost had the man. He almost had the man. Shades of Hacksaw Dugan with the way he goes for things. He just throws caution to the winds, and that caught him right there. That caught him. Less than 1 minute of airtime, Boyd. We'll stay this as long as we can. The grappler trying to kick him, trying to go for that. Look at Chavo launched a drop kick. He blasted grappler clear out on the floor. The grappler was trying to kick him with that loaded boot. Chavo dove out on the floor, and he speared him. He speared him, boy, and I have never seen anything like that. Clear out here on the concrete floor. Boyd Pierce, he just flew through the air, clear down on the concrete floor. And now he's going for the grappler's boot. He's going to try to take off the grappler's boot, Boyd. We'll stay as long as we can.
Bill, our time is about gone. Chavo will be back next week. Tony Atlas, Stagger Lee, they'll all be here.
Chavo's beating the grappler, and he's taking that boot off him. That's one way to stop it.
Thank you, Bill Watts, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us this week. Till next week, I'm Boyd Pearson. Goodbye, everybody, the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network, as the time is all gone. Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's edition of Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. I'm your host, Boyd Pearson. Lots of exciting action. Tag team match sees Colonel Buck Roby join forces with Mr. Wrestling, too. Also, Mr. USA, the muscular Tony Atlas, is here. S. Lee will wrestle on this week's card. Also, the half-line popper Chavo Guerrero will be in action. Right now, our guest commentator of the week, Bill Watts, it looks like a great one.
Well, Boyd Pearson, it's been exciting, and I'll tell you, I wouldn't miss him for all the world. And let's just go to the ring and get to the action, because that Wrestling 2 and Colonel Buck Roby are there waiting.
And it's tag team action now for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 242 pounds from parts unknown, the Grappler. And his partner at 264 pounds from Vancouver, British Columbia, Kelly Kaniski. In the blue corner at 236 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. Wrestling 2. And his partner at 242 pounds from Amarillo, Texas, Colonel Buck Robley.
That's the introduction of the tag team match. Masked Grappler, former North American Heavyweight Champion, his partner Kelly Kaniski, son of the former World Heavyweight Champion Gene Kaniski, and Colonel Buck Robley, nobody calls me yellow in the ring, while his partner outside is the inevitable Mr. Wrestling 2. Bill?
This should be a great match, and you know, Wrestling 2 was a little upset. I saw him talking to Reese Bowden before the matches because of that mask incident last week where somebody had really discolored and ruined one of his masks, and he said he claimed he got a hate note or a threat, and I think Reese Bowden right after this bout is going to be talking to him about it. Wrestling 2, when he comes in the ring, all the fans in the arena go, 2-2-2-2, because this man has had the respect and the admiration of wrestling fans all over the nation for some time. I wrestled him when I was the Georgia heavyweight champion, and I'll guarantee you the first time he hit me in the knee lift, he put my teeth through my lip. He's a rough, rugged guy, asks no quarter and gives none. And there's another individual that's rough and rugged, Colonel Buck Robley. Man's got more steel in his body. He'll set off a metal detector in an airport if they're not careful with all the steel in his arms from injuries and auto wrecks. And still, he goes right on out there and battles. You know, there's some individuals that just have a lot longer career, like Ernie Ladd and Jim Marshall of the Minnesota Vikings, 18 years, 19 years in the NFL, and George Blanda, Kenny Stabler, I mentioned it many times. People are just able to go on and carry on if they don't get that critical injury and they have that intense competitive heart. These guys all have it. Grappler, number one, boy, I bet he's got the laces on that orthopedic boot locked down tight after Chavo Guerrero. I've never seen some of the moves Chavo Guerrero put on him here last week. What an exciting bout. And Chavo Guerrero's back on Mid-South Wrestling. Grizzly Smith jumped right on it and was wanting to be sure that he's going to be here. Grappler's changing blows with Wrestling 2, and I can tell you're going to come in on the short end of the stick with that man. He is just as tenacious as a Georgia Bulldog. Colonel Robley in, and see that subterfuge of Robley. You never know which way he's going to attack. He acted like he was going to forearm Kaniski, and then he led with a low shot into the gut. Kelly Kaniski, a former world's champion son, a rough, tough kid, went to college, played football at West Texas State University. I think he's an up-and-comer, but he's had it hard. He's had to learn the hard way. There's no easy road in wrestling. I guarantee you there's no easy way to let that man hammer your ribs with that vicious knee lift. Ted DiBiase better be watching out for him. Ted DiBiase, Hacksaw Dugan, and now Matt Bourne. Wrestling 2, he popped the grappler again. Colonel Robley drops a reverse elbow in there. Reverse neck breaker. He's got the ball. Grappler comes out. Says, when you're the best in your business, they call you the grappler. Oh, wow. Did you hear that knee lift? Short one into the breadbasket for Kelly Kaniski. The Colonel firing away. Quick tagging by this team. They could be the number one team in contention. Of course, Stagger Lee, when he picks a partner, that's got to be a figured team in that contention for the Mid-South tag titles. What an awesome team if you had Stagger Lee and Tony Atlas. Stagger Lee and Chavo Guerrero. What a Robley almost has the fall. Wrestling 2 and Tony Atlas. Wrestling 2, Buck Robley. A lot of combinations. DiBiase, you're going to have to be looking over your shoulder. You hold all the accolades now. But they're breathing down your neck, and they're starting to pull the same type of subterfuge. They figure if you can fight fire with fire, they're going to, too. Hacksaw Dugan, Louisiana champion. Another man that maybe has bit off more than he can chew. And then the awesome, overpowering Kamala, the Ugandan giant, who we still don't know who pulls the strings on that savage, but he is an awesome, powerful man. He'll be here today. Oh, there's no love lost between these two. This is a man that tried to make a fool of two, and you just don't do that with Wrestling 2 and get away with it. The grappler tried to imitate him. He said he had perfected two's knee lift where he was better than two with it. That didn't work out to be the case. Robley's picking the action up. Kelly Konieski was trying to go in for a leg dive, but his brains were scattered right then. Oh. Kelly Konieski missing with that shoulder tackle into the corner. Robley is such a experienced and moves so well. He's like a cat. And he's been in the ring so long that he can almost anticipate your move. There's wrestling two connecting with that knee lift. Wraps it up with an inside cradle on the leg, and it's a victory for Robley and two. And like I said, Reeser Bowden is wanting to talk to wrestling two to try to clarify or edify us as to what's going on with wrestling two. Reese about moving in to talk to him right now.
Mr. Wrestling Two, would you come over here a moment, please? Just before you came into the ring, I was handed this mask that you wore last week, which obviously is rather badly defaced, and I was handed a note here that says, Two, this is just the beginning. I'm sure that the fans would be very interested to know what this all means.
Well, some clown evidently is trying to destroy Mr. Wrestling Two. You know, I don't harm anybody. I don't get in anyone's way. I mind my own business. I'm extremely a quiet individual. But this is the beginning of something. I don't really know what it is. But I issue a warning to whoever it may be. If when I find out who you are, sir, it'll be D-Day for you. That's a promise. I don't stand and beat my gums for nothing. I'm a quiet man, but this is beyond what is beyond whatever it may be. And when I find out who the individual is, you will pay and pay dearly.
And you know, when Mr. Wrestling 2 says something, he means it. We'll be back with more action right after this word from Mid-South Television Network.
You know, boy, Tony Atlas is one of the strongest men in the world, and he's a great inspiration to youngsters and people that want to develop their God-gifted body. And he's shown us some workouts, and 2 weeks ago they were replaying an old workout of Tony in a gymnasium in Atlanta when he was preparing for the first Mr. USA contest that he won. And Hacksaw Dugan came out and rudely and brusquely interrupted him and challenged him. And let's relive that as Hacksaw Dugan tried to make a fool of Tony Atlas.
What is this? What is this?
Get out of here, get out of here. Get back to that bump. I'm the Louisiana heavyweight champion. There's nothing that happens in this state that I don't have a part of. So right now, I know this guy's got a real nice, pretty, posing body, but that don't make no difference. I played some pro ball. I know what it takes to be a real athlete. Matter of fact, I'll show you what it takes to be a real athlete, Jack. I want to do 20 perfect push-ups, 20 head up, back straight, arm pumping. I want to see if Mr. Pretty Body can do the same perfect push-ups.
All right.
It's 10.
Well, that's 20.
Go on if you can, pretty man.
And Tony Atlas is going to do it.
All right. All right. After that, Boyd Piercy's doing it with one hand. Now he's shifted it. Tony Atlas has answered Mr. Hacksaw Dugan. I love it. He'll face it. Look at him, man, go. He's playing with him. He's playing with him.
Well.
Big deal. Stand back here. Stand back.
Dugan got one, two. I think he ran out of gas.
Dugan will see him do
Dugan
it again.
Dugan will see him do it again. I think Tony's got Dugan's goat. People are telling Tony not to go for it. They better watch Dugan. I hope he's got
it. Well, he's going to do it some more.
Maybe Tony's just so powerful he doesn't care. Dugan started a war. Dugan has started a war. He's trying to take advantage of Mr. USA. I've seen this happen before. I've seen some people try to take action on Tony, but Tony's got that reserve, and it's called heavy-duty power. People are calling for Tony to go. Dugan's setting for that big. He set for the spear, and he hit Tony. But Dugan went down, and Atlas is standing there. Bob Stabler climbing in the ring. Tony Atlas may have been a little bit stunned, but look at him. Look at him, and Dugan. And Atlas has got Dugan opened up like a melon. Dugan is crimson. As Gordon Sully says, he has old face over it. Tony Atlas firing away, and there's Bob Stabler. And now here comes Marty Lundy. And Tony Atlas is cooking. And Dugan's telling him to get out of the ring and stay out of his battle. Hacksaw Dugan wants Atlas all by himself. Dugan is bleeding, but he wants Tony Atlas. But Atlas is stinging him. He's firing away. Look at this ground down. Tony Atlas shows that quickness to go with that streak. And he's hammering Hacksaw. And he's trucking out there. Tony Atlas is walking tall. And Hacksaw Dugan, I think, has had enough. He's had enough.
Hacksaw Dugan met a force that he couldn't spear and run over, as he'd been learned and taught to do since youth in football and being on the suicide squad in the NFL. Tony Atlas may be that immovable object. I will say, to Hacksaw's credit, that badly lacerated, he came back later that same week on the same television show and went ahead and wrestled and totally annihilated his opponent that he was matched by contractually. So Hacksaw Dugan and Tony Atlas still have something to settle. Let's go to the ring now.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 250 pounds from Rome, Georgia, Marty Lundy. And in the blue corner at 252 pounds from Roanoke, Virginia, Mr. USA Tony Atlas.
Introduction now, dressed in black, Marty Lundy from Roman, Georgia. Rick Pereira calls for the bell. His opponent in the red tights, a man who needs no introduction to wrestling fans all over the world, and now capturing the hearts and fancies of the fans here in the Mid-South area, muscular Mr. USA Tony Atlas. Bill?
Well, Tony's a powerful specimen, and he's a real straightforward kid. He loves wrestling, he loves competition, he loves physical exertion, and he goes out there to give it 100%, and he'd rather come out there and wrestle fair and square and do it by skill and technique and strength and conditioning. But let me tell you, he came up the hard way. There was no free handout, there was no gift. He had to learn it all the hard way, and he's no stranger to strife and fighting and scuffling, and he certainly will get it right on. Marty Lundy, a big, powerful youngster, is going to have to learn the same things the same way. And what an awesome man to have to come up against, a man that can bench press in the neighborhood of 600 pounds. We watched him here last week in a strict, strict bench press do 550 pounds. And I was telling you, whoa, and look at the movement. You see, with the power and the strength, you've still got to add one important ingredient, agility. And there Tony Atlas just shows what makes him a superstar. You know, that each one of these guys that are true superstars internationally, you look at them and you watch them and you'll see that they have that something extra. It all starts, of course, in the heart. I was reading an article the other day about Merlin Olsen. When he's in the ninth grade, his football coach told him to go home, that he wouldn't be taken to space and let somebody that was had ability and could possibly become a football player take his place on the team. That was when Merlin Olsen was in the ninth grade. He went on to become a 15-year All-Pro, Hall of Famer, and now a television and movie star. So it all had to be within his heart, because in the ninth grade they sure didn't recognize that tremendous ability and desire in that man. I guess they should go out and lynch that coach for calling himself a coach, because coaches are supposed to recognize that ability and they're supposed to motivate these youngsters. Tony Atlas. Yeah, showing Marty Lundy, if you want to mix it up, he said, we'll just get it on. I notice DiBiase is always trying to put Tony Atlas down. He's saying, well, he's got a Cadillac body and a Volkswagen brain. But I don't see DiBiase in a big hurry to put that title on the line against Tony Atlas or get in the ring with him. He seems to avoid that, and he wants a lot of insulation between him and Atlas. Look at this. Body press and power slam, as only Tony Atlas can do it.
Bill, what a tremendous athlete. Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, gains a victory. We'll see the foot stomping Louisiana heavyweight champion from New York, Hacksaw Dugan, in action after this message from Mid-South.
This is a non-title event for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 270 pounds from New York City, the Louisiana heavyweight champion, Hacksaw Dugan. And in the blue corner at 224 pounds from Anderson, South Carolina, Ted Allen.
Ted Allen being introduced in the green tights versus the big man from New York State, Louisiana heavyweight title holder, Hacksaw Dugan. Jerry Usher called for the bell. Here's Bill.
Hacksaw Dugan, and that's with two G's, as if anybody that makes a mistake and doesn't pronounce it right, he'll certainly tell you. He's an outspoken, loud man. But you know, he's one of those individuals that can back it up. Tough, he has no regard for his own personal safety. His spear is bareheaded, just like he used to with that football helmet in the NFL. Ted Allen, quicker and much movement, and he's popping Dugan with a lot of quick forearms, but you know, it does. It's not how much you hit somebody; it's what you deliver. And he's just like a pea shooter going up against a cannon there, as far as delivery and that type of style. Look at Dugan just run around the ring with him and show him what kind of power he has. Dugan was a New York State amateur wrestling champion in high school, an All-American at SMU, played more starting consecutive games than any man to that period of time there. Hacksaw Dugan, very proud of SMU as their football prowess this year. Louisiana champion, a rough, rugged guy. A man who helped perpetrate probably one of the most infamous or devious schemes ever with DiBiase and Matt Bourne on JYD, forcing JYD to be absent from Mid-South for 90 days, beginning on the 27th of October. JYD cannot wrestle the superstar that has probably excited more fans in the nation than any other superstar, and certainly here in the Mid-South area. Voted king of wrestling in Houston. And Hacksaw Dugan is right in there, and from what I understand, he saw a situation with Mil Máscaras against gorgeous Gino Hernandez in Houston, Texas, where Tully Blanchard had disguised himself in the crowd in a wig and a leather jacket and a baseball hat, and came in and with a foreign object took the measure of Mil Máscaras, the international superstar from Mexico, and with kind of a Trojan horse ploy. And Hacksaw Dugan certainly made a fool of me and Paul Bosch and Boyd Pierce and Charlie Lay, Grizzly Smith, and everybody associated with Mid-South as he duped us that night of the state fair here in Louisiana at the Irish McNeil Boys Club, when he and DiBiase flew in Matt Bourne. And the result is Matt Bourne and DiBiase are the Mid-South tag champions, and JYD is forced out. Oh, he went for a spear, and Allen got out from under him, and the big man may be slightly addled right now. And Allen, quick to press the attack, showing that quickness and speed. And there Allen fires Dugan into it, but Dugan speared him anyway. That's what I mean about this man. He doesn't care. He doesn't care. He just wants to hurt somebody. Hacksaw Dugan, and he wiped Ted Allen out.
A tremendous spear followed by a 1-2-3 count. The victory for the Louisiana Heavyweight Champion, the Big Kamala, the Ugandan Giant, after this message from Mid-South.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the blue corner at 238 pounds from Greensboro, North Carolina, Joe Gaines. Feet 8 inches tall, 385 pounds. Kamala, the Ugandan giant.
Coming to Mid-South, Joe Gaines against across the ring, the big hulk of Kamala, the Ugandan giant, as his handler disrobes him now before the match starts. Bill, this man is tremendous.
Well, boy, he mesmerizes me. I'll tell you, he's huge. He's 385, 400 pounds, 6'8", 6'9", who knows? And again, technique-wise, is a total loss. And I've always thought that no matter how big you were, if you didn't have the technique, that you could be measured and put on your back. But nobody's put him there yet. And he has beat some tremendous men, some powerful men. Iron Mike Sharp just said he was devastating. And look at him go after Joe Gaines. And we still don't know who's in control of Kamala. Although, because of him not being on the Superdome, we understand that there is some maneuvering behind the scenes, and that the man that's pulling the strings on Kamala is going to surface in the very, very near future, because Kamala certainly, credential-wise and by the people he's beaten, he's a factor to definitely be dealt with. And look at him, just, he just body handles people. This, you know, it just, it's almost macabre. It's almost like a throwback, like a nightmare, like you'd be back in Africa of Karl Anstott days, you know, or something like that, back in the very primitive Africa. And you could almost imagine this man in a boiling kettle and some poor missionary being sacrificed. It's Kamala, the Ugandan giant.
And he gains a victory over Joe Gaines. The sensational high-flying star Chavo Guerrero will be in the next match. We invite you to stay with us right after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 240 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, Tony Anthony. And in the blue corner at 224 pounds from Mexico City, Chavo Guerrero.
Tony Anthony in the black tights, and Bill Watts, a man who has plenty of agility in that body and knows how to use it, Chavo Guerrero.
These are both good athletes, and of course, like I say, if you missed Chavo Guerrero last week or ever miss a chance to watch this man, treat yourself, because he is the classic wrestler with a lot of skills, a lot of different style techniques. He can wrestle, he has a scientific background, and also he can stand right in there and fight you. He's just a phenomenal athlete from a great parentage background. He started wrestling at a very young age. He's wrestled all over the world. Truly an international star. Like I say, when you're talking about the international stars of Mexico, the ones recognized in all circles are Mil Máscaras and Chavo Guerrero. And we're very fortunate in having Chavo here, and Mil Máscaras will be coming here in the very near future. These men have been headlining in Houston, Texas. Promoter Paul Bosch and Peter Burkholz, very familiar, and Boyd, you've been there. They excite people. They just have a tremendous ability, tremendous movement and agility. You might say, what would a man like Chavo Guerrero, 220, what chance would he have with a guy like Hacksaw Dugan or Ted DiBiase at 270, Hacksaw 285? Well, let me tell you again, when Chavo Guerrero let the whole wrestling world know that he was for real was when he beat 6'9", 320-pound Ernie Ladd some 4 years ago in Los Angeles. And that speaks louder than everything I could say. And Anthony's wanting to mix it up with him. There's a European slap or type of forearm. It shows, but then he comes right back. And look at the leg strength as he propelled Tony Anthony clear across the ring. Snapmare. tell you, he'll put some holes on you that I'd have to get out of wrestling dictionary, boy, to tell you, because the variations that he puts on are really different. There's a called a surfboard, which extremely popular hole when I first got into wrestling. It seems like we've gotten away from the scientific aspects, but it's also a very debilitating hold. That guy right there, Tony Anthony, is not in position to do a lot. When Chavo's got his arms locked back there like that, they're beyond any place where you can get a strength leverage to get out of it. So he did the smart thing. He went to the ropes to break the hold. Now, that hold looks so simple, but you can demonstrate that in your own living room. Just put your workout partner in that position and see how helpless they are. There, Chavo and Anthony, grip to grip. Trying to power out, see who's got the strength. But Chavo's going to move him. That's the thing about Guerrero. He's not going to let you find out if you can out-strength him. He's going to be moving and making you move. And there he is, right back like a cat, front face lock, belly down where he's got that weight distributed. Now he switches behind into an arm bar. He's a smart man. You know, he knows that sometimes he's going to give away size and strength, but they don't know when they've tested him to that point because he's resilient. He absorbs it and he moves you. There, Anthony firing away. Low shot into the gut. As Tony Anthony is a tough young athlete, shows he can throw a forearm with that European flair at the same time. This is like Dory Funk Jr. and Terry Funk, two world champions. He tried to throw Chavo out, but Chavo blocked it. Chop. And Anthony goes out. Chavo kept him from throwing out. Now, last week we saw Chavo dive through the air, clear out of the. He's going again. Anthony ducked it, but Chavo caught it. Chavo caught it. He's a thinking man. But now look at him over the rope. I don't think Tony Anthony, he wonders which direction you're going to get hit. You're not safe out on the floor or anywhere, Chavo. Chavo going back in the ring, but Anthony pulls him out. Chavo over like a cat onto his feet. But Anthony's regained the high ground, and Chavo's got to come from the hip, from the base of the hill. And that's a rough way to go. Suplex by Anthony. Chavo goes behind him. Belly to belly suplex. Look at the move. Tremendous, exciting man.
Beautiful maneuvers by Chavo Guerrero. And once again, it gains a victory for their popular star. We'll be back with more action. S. Lee coming up after this message from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
Well, boy, Ted DiBiase has been maintaining that S. Lee, or Stagger Lee, is none other than Junkyard Dog. And, of course, Mid-South is taking a neutral position because right. We don't know the identity of Mr. Wrestling 2. We don't know the identity of the grappler. We didn't know the identity of the man in the gorilla suit either. So in order for DiBiase to prove it, he has to unmask S. Lee. If he unmasks S. Lee and it is the Junkyard Dog, then the Junkyard Dog is in violation of his contract and will be suspended from Mid-South. And last week, DiBiase and Matt Bourne decided they would unmask S. Lee. Let's join the final few seconds of that attempt as they did unmask A. S. Lee. Stagger Lee firing back now. He throws one at DiBiase, and as he turns his back, Matt Bourne catches him. Body slam. Matt Bourne going for the bombs away off the top turnbuckle. Matt Bourne dropping on Stagger Lee. Now DiBiase in there. Crowd cheering him. They pulled the mask off. It's not Junkyard Dog, but there's another Stagger Lee in there. That other Stagger Lee is firing away. Well, I'm sure DiBiase and Matt Bourne are more than frustrated. That doesn't change the issue. If they can unmask Stagger Lee and prove that it's a Junkyard Dog beyond any shadow of doubt, Mid-South's hands would be tied and the ruling would have to come down to enforce a year's suspension. However, they only have 90 days to do that from its original contractual stipulation that Dog would leave Mid-South for 90 days starting on the 27th of October. So they've only got a few more days or month, a little over a month remaining in order to get this unmasking done and proved. But we'll go to the ring right now, and whatever, we're going to enjoy it because we're going to see Stagger Lee.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 300 pounds from Moscow, Russia, Vladik Smirnov. Coming into the ring now, at approximately 265 pounds from no one knows where, Stagger Lee.
Stagger Lee versus Russian Vladik Smirnov. Rick Ferreira called for the bell in the battle zone, Bill.
I guarantee you Stagger Lee isn't wasting any time as he comes into the music of Stagger Lee and says, is it me, Stagger Lee? And I got to admit, I've got to sit down and wow. Smirnov almost went right down on the concrete on his bald head, and I don't care where you're from, that's got to hurt. Again, I think we ought to get with Grizzly Smith and Charlie Lay and find out just what the deadline is on Junkyard Dog as far as his 90 days out of Mid-South, because apparently it's going to become a big problem. I'm sure DiBiase is putting out the word all over the country. There's a lot of money. Wow, what a clothesline. Put out a word all over the country that anybody that can unmask Stagger Lee, bringing that mask and prove that it's a Junkyard Dog, will collect a lot of extra money. But right now it's Stagger Lee, and he just annihilated that Russian bear.
In quick time, Stagger Lee the winner. Tag team action coming up after this important message from Mid-South Wrestling.
And now a non-title tag team event for one fall or remaining television time in the red corner. The Mid-South Tag Team Champions at 265 pounds from Omaha, Nebraska, not only co-holder of the Mid-South Tag Team Belt, but also the North American Heavyweight Champion, Ted DiBiase. And his partner at 240 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Matt Bourne. In the blue corner at 234 pounds from Chula, Mississippi, King Cobra. And his partner at 218 pounds from Knoxville, Tennessee, Tim Horner.
Tag team action now, the popular team of King Cobra and Tim Horner against the rugged, arrogant duo of Ted DiBiase and Matt Bourne.
It's a great match, a lot of speed. Mid-South Tag Team Champions. DiBiase and Matt Bourne. Lots of things going on. Well, Stagger Lee didn't waste any time and just annihilating Vladik Smirnov. DiBiase out there and young Tim Horner, who's a real burner. He can flat move. He's got the big man from West Texas State who are a little bit upset. Of course, DiBiase, I think, is upset about the whole Stagger Lee situation. It's interesting to me how injured he can be when somebody is trying to perpetrate on him almost an identical situation that he's perpetrated on them. He's even complained about Stagger Lee using a foreign object in the mask. And of course, as if, Jerry Usher caught Matt Bourne. That's illegal in Mid-South. You can't come off the top turnbuckle. You can't leap on your opponent from the top turnbuckle. Usher right on the ball. He stopped Matt Bourne. Only time that's legal is in a no disqualification match, as Matt Bourne used a few weeks ago to wipe out Mr. Olympia to help DiBiase. And he gets Olympia out of the way, and eventually with the help of Dugan in the gorilla suit to get the Junkyard Dog. We'll have Mr. Olympia back here on Mid-South Wrestling next week. Whoa, Chula. King Cobra shows that he can boogie. Rocking on, this is one ball of television time remaining, and these youngsters have really got the crowd behind them. That's great when you see them giving two arrogant, rough individuals that have all the honors, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. Get them out of their game plan. Matt Bourne, whose father, Tough Tony Bourne, very rugged individual. Ted DiBiase, his father, Iron Mike DiBiase, is also a national AAU champion and a Big Seven champion from Nebraska. The those of you in the Oklahoma City area know that the NCAA National Wrestling Finals will be hosted by OU and OSU, Oklahoma City beautiful Myriad Center. And of course, Mid-South Wrestling is in the Myriad Center. King Cobra firing away. What a great match today, boys. We want to thank everybody for inviting us into their home again. I want to make mention that Dean Ward, the general manager of Channel 26, Independent 26 in New Orleans, called and was tremendously pleased that Mid-South Wrestling was the number one show in its time segment in the city of New Orleans, and that's just fantastic. And we're real happy for Dean Ward. We're happy for Mid-South Wrestling. But you, the viewers and the fans, the people that tune us in, are the ones that allow us to have that honor, and we want to thank you sincerely. Oral Link, the director, Paul White, the cameraman, they do a terrific job. Ah, Matt Bourne found out that King Cobra has got a rugged tag behind. DiBiase getting set, coming off. They got a 4-second break count there, and these guys know how to run it right out to the last second to where they're double teaming the guy. They try to keep the guy wearing down with a fresh man on him. Not how much television time left, Boyd. Ball right there, looks like. No, King Cobra got out. About 2 minutes of television time remaining. King Cobra and Tim Horner can hold these men to a draw. What a feather it'd be in their cap. And I'm sure Wrestling 2 and Buck Robley are watching every move right now, as is Stagger Lee, as is Mr. USA Tony Atlas, Chavo Guerrero, Wrestling 2. A lot of people very interested. Whoa, and Matt Bourne found out he came to a sudden stop. And there's Tim Horner firing away. This youngster is really a pleasure to watch. Great little competitor. And he shows Mr. DiBiase. Wow, he's, like I said, he's a burner. He's got the energy and the, he gets out there and goes. He went for that drop kick, and DiBiase with that tremendous peripheral vision and experience saw it coming, got out of the way. Clothesline, tag, fresh man, legal man Matt Bourne. Double arm whip in using that 4 second. Power slam, Matt Bourne. Matt Bourne with a power slam, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions retain their supremacy in the ring in this non-title bout. And boy, another great day with Mid-South Wrestling, and we'll see next week Mr. Olympia returning. Gorgeous Gino Hernandez, Hiro Matsuda, and Yoshiyatsu from Japan, a man who was a member of the Japanese Olympic team. So lots of big things coming.
Bill, it's just a terrific card coming up next week, like it is every week on Mid-South Wrestling. Thank you so much. As our guest commentator, an articulate word picture, you just can't be beat. And I say that sincerely. You folks at home, as our loyal viewers and watchers, you can't be beat. You're humble hosts because you make me that way. I love you and appreciate you. Thank you for viewing. Until next week on the same channel, Boyd Pearson. Goodbye, everybody, from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.